EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to the Sooner State and the hardworking capital of Oklahoma City. Today, on to Week 15 in the NFL, and we've got a good matchup in store, as it'll be the Dragons of Mexico City taking on the Redwoods of Oklahoma City. Here now to get us started is Logan Cook, and off we go from OKC. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. And they'll begin by running the option. And he probably should have given that one off as he's going to get hit and taken down behind the line. So the first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. Here's Fields. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down. They need a crafty play call here. 14 yards is what they need to try to convert this thing.
That was the first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
Taking it about the 36. 49-yard punt, five on the return. And it will be first and 10 as they take over. Starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. They'll start on the ground, ETN. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and 3. Now Lawrence. Oh, his first throw of the game, going to be intercepted. And he'll take this back all the way up past the 45-yard line.
They'll take over first down 10 at their own 46-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. They start near midfield following the interception as they begin first and 10. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Second and 10. Now it's Fields. Caught left side. It's Beckham. And a gain of 4 gets him right to the midfield stripe. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. From the 50, here's Fields. That ball nearly intercepted, but he could not hang on. Pick there certainly would have been nice. Instead, at least it'll be fourth down. Here's Corey Bohorquez now. And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. It'll go as just a 15-yard punt. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. As we grind toward the end of the season here, and they haven't had the season that they had hoped, so let me ask you to play GM. Where might they look to make some changes?
I think when you look into the upcoming draft, think hard about them drafting multiple offensive linemen. They've got to get stouter up front. And as a GM always tells me, Charles, this is a big boy league, and big people always end up winning games for you.
Deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. Not that time for Watkins, and it'll bring up third down. Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. Able to find the open man. complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. An excellent pickup of 20 yards.
And that's how you shake off the interception you throw on the opening drive, come back and throw another strike, and gain nice yardage. And I give credit to two people on this one. The man throwing the ball and the person calling the plays. They're not shutting him down early in this game.
That's caught by his tight end, Evan Ingram. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. The catch and run going to wind up netting him 33 yards. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
And a smart play there. He's probably saying, I wish I would have done that on the last drive instead of throwing the interception.
Now a second and 10. Looking to throw, Lawrence. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
That was not a real confident throw right there, and he's just 2 of 7 to start the game. Now he's going to have to find a groove with a big third down coming up. Let's see if his confidence can increase.
Throwing again here, it's Lawrence. That'll be caught by Rice. And he'll get inside the 10, but he's short of the line he needed. So the completion good for 7 there. And it'll be fourth down.
Well, we hear so often how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game, but it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. Third down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go and make the tackle right away.
Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call.
Oh, just a crushing penalty there. You force the incompletion on fourth down, but bail him out by roughing the passer.
And if you want to see barely controlled fury, take a look at the sideline. Take a look at the head coach. A dumb, dumb penalty there on fourth down.
So a critical mistake, roughing the passer. Now it's first and goal. And they'll run it here. And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Chris Watkins, his first rushing touchdown of the year. And the Redwoods get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon.
This feels like something we'd see more commonly, CD, in a college game. They give it to the receiver down here in the red zone, but it winds up successful.
Yeah, partner, I think you think it's less likely to find running space to the edge down here close to the end zone when things are so condensed. But a lot of times you end up focusing on the running backs, and they're able to slip it to the receiver, and it resulted in a touchdown.
And he'll elect not to run with it. And a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. Not only are they in search of their first score, they're in search of their first down in this ball game as they come up first and 10.
Back to throw, Fields.
And that is incomplete.
Cole Kmet, the intended receiver,
but it'll be second down.
Hey, look at this defense.
They've been pretty good against the pass. Not amazing, but good. Number 13 in the league.
I think if you talk to their head coach, you'll get a nice answer about how much he likes his team and what they're doing. But at the end of it, he would admit there's definitely room to improve.
Now a first down throw, Fields.
Over the middle to Beckham.
And he's going to be taken down. Plus, there's a penalty flag in the backfield. They may get 15 more on top of this.
So now a fresh set of downs. First and 10 after roughing the passer.
From the gun, here's Fields. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down. Throwing again is Fields.
As they work it inside the 10 to the 7. That's good for 28 yards.
And they'll try the option on first and goal.
And he's brought down.
smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. Up the middle, Johnson. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the 5 down to the 3. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. On to the second quarter. Mexico City in possession, as they'll see what they can do on third and goal. Johnson again, and he's not going too far. In fact, stopped dead in his tracks at the 3. And no hesitation about this decision here. Confidently, they're going to go for this. Fourth and goal from the 3. Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete. An incompletion there on fourth and goal from the 3. And the ball will go over on the goal line stand. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Things progressing to plan so far. Their defense has been solid, and they've got themselves a 7-0 lead after the touchdown the last time they had the ball.
And this is no time to even think about, hey, are we going to milk the clock? Hey, are we just going to do ball control? This is the NFL. 7-0 leads, they don't last very long unless you continue to push the envelope on offense.
Now a 2nd and 6. Lawrence will throw. He's got Watkins on the out route. And he'll go out of bounds just shy of the 20. First catch for him. It's good for a dozen and a first down. Lawrence. Flushed out right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up 2nd down. Out of the gun, it's Lawrence. A short throw to Ingram. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 2nd catch for him today, and it'll wind up a 1st down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Again, it's Lawrence. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now 2nd down.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now after getting walked backwards on this drive. Come through with another one here, and you have them staring at a 3rd and long, and that puts the defense in a position to dictate to the offense.
Escaping the pressure right. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's 3rd.
I would say it'd probably be a good idea for him to reintroduce himself to his receivers at the half because they're definitely on different wavelengths. But I also don't advocate waiting that long. Next series, before you get out there, hey, let's get together, guys. Let's get this thing moving.
Now a shot taken on 3rd down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
On is the punter, Townsend, as he gets this one away. Fielded at the 20. Pushing his way through. A good return there, call it 13 yards. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And last time, they had it 4th and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive.
Yeah, simple. Tip of the cap, a nod in the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow them to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do. From the 41, here's 2nd and 5. Now Fields. Got an open man, it's Scott. So just 3 yards on the completion there. And it makes it 3rd down and 2 yards to go. To throw is Fields. And it'll be touched down here, but not before he does pick up the 1st.
yard pickup. And the Mexico City first down.
Fields now to throw. Flush to his right. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. The escapability in evidence there is that one. Good for 15 and a first. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. On the option right is Fields. And holding it, maybe the wrong decision as he stopped in the backfield. Here's Fields now on second down. Over the middle, it's complete. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Johnson. We'll get down close to the goal line, but not in, as he'll be marked down at the 1. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal. Second and goal from the 1. To Johnson again. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. His 5th rushing touchdown on the year, number 7 overall. And the Dragons are an extra point away from evening this one up. Santos with the extra point, and that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity. So many times we've seen him try to escape the pocket and do something with his legs, but in this case, the pressure was too intense and he made the wise choice to just get rid of the football and make sure no one was going to get it.
And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number 1. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. On 3rd and 1, it's Lawrence. Looking for Watkins, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jaquan Brisker. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. Fields on 1st down. That'll be caught. It's Scott. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. On 1st down, Fields. And he's going to be hit and taken down. Back right around the 48-yard line. Fields going to hurry his guys to the line. After the sack on 1st down, Fields. Quick hitter here, it's complete. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on 1st down. They didn't get all of it back. But now they look at 3rd down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number 2. Now with 5 seconds left, not really enough time to run another play and then stop it. So on comes the field goal unit. Santos' kick is up and through, and they take the lead here now at 10-7. So the turnover leads to points as they add 3 there.
Yeah, what a sequence there, and a nice win for them. They force the interception, put together a little drive, and then come away with 3 points. Nothing to it, partner. Just do it.
Time for a break. We've hit halftime. 2 quarters down. 2 still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon.
A good, tight football game thus far. 10-7 the score as we resume action on EA Sports.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive.
Well, Charles, we saw a pretty entertaining first half, close ball game. Remember there toward the end of the second quarter, the opposition scored to take the lead. Now we'll see if these guys can get a score of their own to regain that lead.
Yeah, they want to have that type of a response, don't they? Because they want to find a way to take control of this ball game one more time. Gauntlet's been thrown down. They want to see if they're ready to answer it.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Here's Lawrence. Going deep here for Watkins. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Well, they certainly aren't letting up today, partner, because they've forced big turnovers already, and it's been incredibly tough for them to get yards against, let alone put points up on the board.
On second down, a run with Etienne. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
Work in the middle. He's got a man complete. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Where they pick up 25 as they convert on third.
Off the play fake. Here's Lawrence.
Dancing to his left. Airs it out toward the corner of the end zone. And it's incomplete. Took a shot. Couldn't connect.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been any. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
Well, that's the third interception for Lawrence.
And the return will stop right around the 25. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And their defense just helped them out by getting the football back on the opening drive here in the second half. And now can the offense follow through with points on their first possession?
That's a big one for them because after the work the defense has done, they've got a chance here to open up this lead.
Here's Fields.
Pressure comes and down he goes. Josh Allen, make that now 8 sacks for him on the season. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't come in. Had to pass there, third and long on your own side of the field. Just couldn't come up with anything.
That's why teams always talk about having to win the early downs, meaning you've got to gain yardage and set yourself up for third and short, because when it's third and long, the odds go down significantly trying to pick up the first down, even throwing the football.
It'll be a 47-yard punt with a net of 40 following a 7-yard return. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
But the passing windows are just not there, and that's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
On third down, Lawrence. And they'll find the open man. That's complete. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. And it's a big play there on third down. And even 50 yards. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10.
They'll try and set up the screen to ETN.
And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
And good yardage there on first down, because sometimes all you need to do on the screen is get one key block. That might set your man free, and that was pretty good pursuit to the football defensively, or it could have gone for more.
And he gets halfway there, down to the 1 yard line. Only a yard there on the keeper, and that's going to leave him with a third down. This defense against the run, by the way, they're not top 5, but they are top 10.
So what's your philosophy here? Do you try and run the ball against a team that's pretty good against the run? What if you're a pretty good running team?
And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. Travis Etienne with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Redwoods have retaken a third quarter lead. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead is now 14-10.
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive.
On first down, it's Fields. Getting this out to the flat, Mostert.
Call it a gain of 3 on the play, and it'll be second down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now.
Back to throw, Fields.
This is caught by his tight end, Logan Thomas. They'll try and run here with Mostert, and he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
From the gun, here's Fields.
And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. 2 yards on the pickup there, and it's second down.
Out of the gun, Fields. Finding Johnson on the out route. That's complete.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10.
Now it's Fields.
And that is incomplete. Now the coverage a little too good there. And it's second down.
It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Here's Fields. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Antonio Johnson.
And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Another important fourth quarter series coming up. That last INT helping to maintain their slim advantage. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Some teams like to start aggressive to begin a drive, but this is still what you expect to see in normal situations. Just call a simple run, get a few yards and begin the series, and set yourself up for something bigger on second down.
All right, let's go.
Ball spotted at the 45. Here's second down and seven. Here's Lawrence to throw. And that'll be incomplete. And it took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down. Lawrence will throw. And it is caught. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. That one good for 15 and a first. They go play action now. Lawrence, he's going to look deep for Watkins. That is incomplete.
Just because you got the lead before, that doesn't mean you have to play it safe. I like the aggressive play call there to push it downfield. That time, it didn't work out.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
Now Lawrence.
Completes it to Evan Engram. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 17 yards is the pickup there for number 17.
On first and 10. Oh, no, he lost the football. Oh, one of the linebackers has got it.
And he'll bring this one back to the 29.
Well, partner, here's where team football gets tested a little bit, because I know the defensive guys were over there chilling on the sidelines, and all of a sudden, they heard the sudden change call, because that fumble puts them right back on the field, and they've got to go out and finish the game now themselves.
Absolutely. Nursing that slim lead here in the fourth, a costly turnover. On second down, Johnson.
And space tough to come by there as he'll get maybe a yard to the 37.
This is third and two. Maybe the biggest play in this football game.
He's got his target. That's complete.
And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. They get 9 yards there and they get a first down.
Now Fields,
eluding the pressure right. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
Fields now to throw.
It's a short one here, complete to his tight end.
All three timeouts plus the two-minute warning. Here's first and 10. To throw his Fields.
It's a short one here, complete to the tight end.
Here comes second down at five. Fields
sliding out of the pocket. We've got a one-score game with inside of 2 minutes remaining. So it's our visitors with a football as we get you reset.
Well, this crowd into it now. Third and two. Here's Fields. Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. Picked off by Tyson Campbell.
And he will take this all the way up past the 40-yard line.
Well, you knew you had to take some chances here with the clock winding down, needing a touchdown to win it, and that one might have just sealed their fate.
Yeah, and that's the nature of the two-minute drill, the offense trying to go downfield and make their plays. But defenses, they're sitting back watching everything that they do, but not too far back. They want to be in position to make a play on the ball, and that they do.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
And when you've thrown as many interceptions as he has in this one, you definitely start getting a little hesitant to throw the ball out wide, because that's prime pick six territory. That time, he made sure the only guy who was going to catch it was sitting in the third row.
Lawrence's throw taken in by Watkins here.
On the move past the 40.
And he is out of bounds inside the 35. Probably the only thing he did wrong there was go out of bounds, nursing his fourth quarter lead. You want to stay in, eat the clock.
Yeah, you got to love the effort, the catch, the extra yardage, but you got to know the situation. Stay in bounds, young man.
Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
Second down and six now.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. He's got Watkins on the out route. Still finding.
And even though he gets out of bounds to stop the clock, it's not going to matter. That first down going to be enough to write a finish to this one. A shotgun snap and again the ETN.
And he will take this one in for a touchdown.
Travis Etienne,
his second touchdown of the game and his ninth on the year.
And the Redwoods look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here in this fourth quarter.
Extra point right down the middle. And that makes it a 21-10 game.
After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. Fair catch going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25. They'll come up first and 10 here.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's going to let it fly. And this one is incomplete.
When you're leading in the final quarter, your radar has to be up for any potential deep shots. And probably not the last one they're going to see in this game, not as long as they hold this lead.
Nowhere for Fields to turn, and down he goes.
Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game.
This crowd turning up the decibel level. It's third and long. Here's Fields.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. That's caught at the 25.
This is first and 10.
Back to throw. Fields. And he's brought down after a very nice game.
Mostert diving for the end zone, and he is in. Touchdown.
Problem for them, they needed that score with a little more time left on the clock. I think just too little too late now.
I would agree with that. We're programmed never to say never, but in this case, we're asking a lot for them to even think they have it.
Hammering for the goal line. He loses the football.
And that was ball picked up by the offense. But here in the final 2 minutes of the game, this will be blown dead. Only the fumbler can advance the football. So this will go back to the spot of the fumble itself.
So they tried to tack on two more. Wouldn't have mattered as far as who won and who lost, but that's how this one ends.
Felt like cosmetics, didn't it? Just put another 2 points on the board, make the score look a little bit better. Maybe they wanted to run a two-point conversion just to see what they...
was my moment of truth. I was a year away from not being known as a youth. Approaching man. powers. Deceased presidents in the wall in my residence as I increase stepping on ballin' forever while kissing the sweet melanin of a broad that I met in the Netherlands. Address me as Marcus Clay.